Hello everybody, this is Satoshi Yamamoto. Today, I'd like to redo my coyote. Well, first of all, thank you very much for watching my videos and checking up my blog. And then several people responded to me, hey, that's a beautiful fly. But also, they told me it's in such a poor quality. No, especially after I figured out the angle and positioning of my camera, or how it works, you know, how it work. I mean, yeah, how to have it work. Yeah, so like this, it's gotta have it focus on right here. So today I just wanna do quickly with not much stories behind. Just wanna show you. Beautiful fly again. Okay, hook, Daiwiki 280 or Mountain Fly Company, 7231, 2x long carved hook, and then the thread I'm using. Like I said, originally I used the Piercer's Gossamer Silk. It's a beautiful material, however, for the practicality and of, you know, mass production, I switched into Router thread 140, burnt orange. Okay, so this is always stop at the point. I kind of go back where I started. Reason I started here is I don't want a bulk, you know, for the future steps. Okay, what I'm gonna use here is a Zeron or Dalon Zeon, and then. This is kind of full bundle. I don't want a full bundle, maybe a half of it. I have learned over the years of tying, and then especially for this video, what makes kind of beautiful body. Okay, about a half length of the hook shank and the tail. I like definitely brown fibers from a pheasant. Just about these things. So I transfer that. I lap the axis here. I'm gonna tie in. You know, my original recipe is called for either gold or copper wire, but today I did a bit different. As I said in my first video. My guide mentor Tom Travis gave me this. you're not gonna find this in your local store because this is from Amateur. But then Tom harvested it and kindly gave it to me. So this is going to make a distinctive ribbing, which you're gonna see in a minute. Okay, I'm going to make a tapered body with thread wraps. So I'll try to make it a bit fatter on here than the rear side. Yeah, I'm getting there. Original recipe called for, I said, counter wrap, but it doesn't really matter. So, well, actually, I countered it, but see how distinctive ribbing. I came to like this material immediately. One more just for the holding sake. This is gonna be under the thread anyway, so. I don't want this one to kind of slip, you know. So. It's a made awkward. Oh, in the wrap. Okay, now I come back to zero again. Excuse me, I dropped my whip finish. Okay. It's been recorded, no mess, I guess. This is a wing, and I call it the underwing, but this is into the thorax. Finger 8 drop, I just do it one more time. Okay. You can hold this, you can position this as a delta wing style like this, on both sides, but also you can hold together, hold both of them, and then top, you know, position on the top like this. Either way it works, and then the will turn out a beautiful fly. So length from the end of the body, thread body, I measure like this and cut it. Okay. Now I'm building up some box. That's why I don't want to start the thread from here. So now, final two materials, rump feather and the aftershaft plume that comes with it. I try not to say that either, yeah. Okay, spring loaded hackle pyre. Two tons. Three turns to secure my aquaria. Last material is aftershaft. Tip very fragile. All the way to the hook eye. Okay. Last step, make a whip finish. I'm sorry, build a tiny, neat head in here, then apply beeswax on the thread like this. Form a nice little head here. There. Okay, here you go. This is my original coyoted pheasant soft tackle. I hope now you can see it better, and then enjoy tying and going fishing with it. So. Thank you for watching, and then have a nice day.